Hey guys, good morning. Just to give you a little bit of context as to what's going to be happening today, I'm going to be vlogging at an outlet mall. Right, so we are out of lockdown here in New South Wales, and I thought I'd take you with me as I go to the outlet mall here called Birkenhead Point. Two reasons why I'm going there. There's a big Kohl's supermarket there, so I'm going to do my weekly shop over there. But the second reason is I am on the lookout for new running shoes for myself and the husband. Now, I know that you guys know that I am much more of a pre-loved kind of person, but I think in terms of like training or running shoes, I need to buy it new so that it molds to my feet and not onto somebody else's feet, and also because I wanted to still have some traction and cushioning while I'm wearing it, because usually when you buy secondhand, the shoes are already worn in, right? So those are the two reasons that I'm going there, and I thought that since I'm gonna be heading over there, then I might as well take you guys with me. Now the thing is, okay, let's do a little bit of OODD. We are in our spare bedroom where I film. As you can see there, the ring light, and I have some of my, these are my winter clothes that are packed away. These are clothes that are going on donation. Those are my makeup and a lot of shit over there. This is where I usually watch TV, because the big TV in the living room is often occupied by my husband when he is watching Netflix. Okay, so OOTD, this is a 100%, I know, I think it's 95% organic cotton from Target that I've had for at least a year now. Cargo pants, this is because I couldn't get my hands on Karen Britchick's cargo pants release, so I got this from, I think it's the Iconic. It's by the brand Misguided. I'm not a big fan of the fabric as it's polyester. It even says keep away from flammable materials. So I might just burst into flames. Secondhand Converse Runstar Hike that I got from the Facebook Marketplace. I really like the look of this, but they are not the most comfortable shoes I own. The platform gives me an uneven stride, so I don't know about that. Anyway, that's my coffee that I haven't drank. But I am undecided on which bag to take with me. I am lean. Oh, you glimpse that, don't you? That's coming, or you would have already seen that if you watched last Sunday's video. But I'm thinking I'm taking my Balenciaga hip bag, and I've attached the original strap on it because I am planning on carrying it as sort of like a baguette shoulder carry rather than the crossbody that I normally wear it as. But because this strap is long enough, I could actually still carry it as crossbody. The strap is actually too long, which is the reason why I decided that I was just going to use the Coach one that you would see there. Anyway, this is a very long intro. Let me go ahead and drink my coffee. That's the Christian Dior mini Boston bag that is up on eBay at the moment. And this arrived from Vessier Collective. You will see some photos of it. I did unbox it, but I didn't remove any of the tags because I decided that I'm not going to keep it. I'm going to resell this. So that's actually up on Facebook Marketplace at the moment. An empty box and a lot of other shit over there. Anyway, right. So yeah, that's what we're doing today. I'll talk to you later. Okay, so it's apparently 16 degrees outside, so I decided to pair this Sisley denim jacket that I got secondhand as well. I think this is from, what's it, that shop called? Oh, I forget. Anyways, so here's the whole look now. There we go. Okay, oh, and obviously face mask, because we're still required to wear a face mask indoors.
Okay, guys, so I am driving to Birkenhead Point, but the first thing that I do, because we don't own this car, this is a shared vehicle we have go get here in Sydney. And the first thing that I do before I touch anything is take a wipe, wipe down the handles, wipe down everything that I'm going to touch, including the seats, just to be sure. This is a Dettol wipe, by the way. Right, so I'm a little bit nervous. I'm a little bit nervous because I don't know if I remember how to drive after having been cooped up for about 4 months. But yeah, let's go. Right, we're here. So I've just parked. It's 8:30 in the morning, by the way. And the reason why I came early is because I know that it's the first weekend after the lockdown has been lifted, so it's gonna be busy. I didn't want to miss out on parking. All right. So I actually thought I'd start off with the grocery shopping, just because most of the shops are still closed since I arrived so early. Jesus, this thing's all right. Okay, asparagus. The broccolis are so small. Okay, that's fine. I bring my own bags just to reuse them. Because you know I'm Asian, I keep them all under the sink. Let's see. Okay, so far there aren't a lot of people here today, or at least not yet. Just the reason why I came in early. Here's a glimpse of what's in my healthy-ish. Ooh. Let's see, what do we need? So I'm done with most of it. I didn't buy any meat because that's gonna get bought somewhere else. So I'll put this in the car and then we'll continue. Okay, so the shops are starting to open, but some are still like, they start at I think 10 o'clock. I wanna get in here because these are the ones that carry like the designer items. Same thing on this side here. I don't know if that's still that because it's been a while. You got Bali there. Earlier I showed you Coach. Oriton is an Australian brand. I would say they are a premium brand, but not luxury designer. And they've got a massive sale. 50% of everything on original price. And oh, it's actually saying 60% off. Says 50? 60. So we'll see. There's quite a few famous outlets here. There's a Tommy Hilfiger, there's a Ralph Lauren, Hugo Boss, Furla, Michael Kors. Also got Armani, Converse. I know there's an Adidas and a, what do you call this? Nike, Puma, Asics or Asics. I don't know how you say that. Hugo Boss is already open. We got a suit from them, bought secondhand. Ooh, the Armani outlet is renovating. Yep. Okay. Okay, so if you didn't know already, I'm the kind of person who would like to tick off my to-do list first before doing anything else. So I've done the supermarket run. Now I'm gonna go and find us some running shoes and then I'll go visit the other shops afterwards. So on the highest level, you got your homeware, bed, bath, and table. Then you got Skechers, North Face. Oh, Asics is right there. I passed it. Adairs, Cotton On. Spotlight is like a, how do I say? It's not a die sell because they're not that cheap, but you know, sort of like home stuff. Oh, Asics is closed. I don't wonder what time they open or if they're gonna open at all today. There you go, 10 a.m. Anyway, I got the car until 11:30 so I can come back later.
Converse is on buy one, get 50% off on additional item. And the Nike outlet doesn't open till 10 o'clock. I also tried my luck at potentially getting a haircut, but that was a no-go. They're all fully booked, and I assume just as much. So as you can see, some of the shops are still closed. They probably will open at 10, because there's already like staff in them, but they're just not opening their doors yet. So I'm trying to find which ones are open that I can go into. Not that I need anything, or want anything for that matter. So Witchery, another Australian brand. And as expected, most of the things that are on sale are from their winter collection. Ooh, French Connection. Shall we go in there? Nah. Here we go. I think I'm just gonna stick to buying what we need. And just to show you, oh, I can't really show you the view from here, but okay, now I can show you the view. Birkenhead Point is actually along the Parramatta River. Well, I think at least it's the Parramatta River. You've got a wharf right outside. Must be wonderful to live in one of those apartments there. So Adidas is still closed. I'm not sure if they're gonna open today, because I mean, look at those boxes blocking the entrance. But Levi's is open, and they're on buy one, get one free. Wow, okay, let's do that. I mean, Lord knows I don't need any more jeans, but here you go, have a look at what is available for buy one, get one. Denim jackets are buy one, get one. T-shirts are buy one, get one. These jeans are buy one, get one. This balloon pants are cute, but they're not my size. Like, this one's 31, this one's 32, and this one's 31. I'm a 28. And you got this high loose ones, that's high rise and then loose leg. That's really cute, but again, not my size. I thought this was a skirt, but turns out they're trousers. So I was just talking to the staff, and it turns out everything is buy one, get one free. So yeah, even the ones that are priced $39, if you buy two of them, you're only paying $39. I gotta say, I was really tempted by that. That's the problem with this big sales, is that you really want to buy even if you don't need it. So I left. So we're at the Ralph Lauren shop. $99, none. Is this... Now, one of the things that I look out for, now that I'm more conscious about shopping, is what the material is. 90% wool, 10% cashmere. Oh, that's really good. And for $99, that's not bad at all. And then, if you are familiar with Philippine politics, pink is Lenny Robredo's color, and I think I need one.
Right, so I'm home, and now I want to show you what I got. Let me warn you, they're both pink. Tommy Hilfiger is a white, I think it's called Nantucket tee in floral pink. This was 50% off, so I only paid $25 for it. This is in a size medium. This is men's, so this is going to be quite large for me, but I prefer my t-shirts to actually be quite loose. And in Ralph Lauren, I bought another pink shirt. And this one is in XL because they're slim, skinny fit. And I don't really like skinny fit. Like, it shows off my bulges. So I bought them two sizes up. I'm usually a medium. Yeah, so I bought this in XL. And this was $89. I don't usually wear pink, but because I am campaigning for one of the, well, the only female presidential back in the Philippines, I thought I should have a pink shirt. I actually ordered one that specifically had Kaileni Ako written on the t-shirt. So there we go. Anyway, so much noise outside. It's kind of windy. I still need to go to the fish market, so I am going to end the vlog here. Thanks for watching. Alright you guys, so I'm back from the fish market, and as you can see, I bought myself some lunch. Because I didn't have anything except coffee, I obviously bought more than I can eat. See, that's the problem when you buy and you're hungry. In Filipino, we call that takaw mata. Takaw mata. Okay, so your eyes are hungry. Okay? Anyways, I'm gonna end the video here. Thanks so much for joining me today. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section down below. Bye.